morning, and thank you very much. Today's Tuesday in Albany, as everybody knows, so it's a very hectic and busy schedule, but this is a preeminent issue for communities all across the state of New York, for the people that we all represent. And I had mentioned this recently in my office now, and certainly in my new office as well. I have a framed set of campaign materials from my father's first election. He served in the assembly from 1972 to 1986. And in his campaign brochures in 1972, one of the big issues was property taxes. That was 43 years ago. So people were talking about it then, they're going to talk about it now. And that, I think, is probably underscores why making the property tax cap permanent is in the best interest of taxpayers and the people of the state of New York. I want to thank Heather, the Business Council, NFIB, Unshackle, Empire Center. Had the opportunity to work with these groups for a long period of time. And the more we can do to keep property taxes down, the better off we are as an economy, as an estate. And I think it has a ripple effect in so many different ways. So a couple of basic things. $7.6 billion since 2012, that's real money. And that's something that taxpayers can understand. And in reality, that keeps money in their pockets, which is good for every person in the state of New York. You know, and another thing that I think is important, for a number of years, New York State would be guilty of don't do as I do, but rather do as I say. And under Governor Cuomo's tenure, working with the legislature, we have collectively, in essence, lived within a property tax cap, even though we don't have one at the state level. I think that's very important because we're not asking people to do things that we're not doing as a state voluntarily. Let me be clear, the Senate has advanced the property tax cap being permanent before. We had it in our One House budget resolution. We're going to pass that legislation again. We want to set the tone and tenor and content of debate. And we have also advocated and passed on multiple occasions a state spending cap. So we are being consistent in terms of our advocacy, which in the end is really about the taxpayers of the state of New York. So I don't want to belabor the point. I want to make it clear where our conference is, where we've stood, where we are now, and where we think things need to go. And it is, again, if we do this the right way, it's good for all the people of the state of New York. And I know that may be an oversimplification, but that's when you get to the core of it, that's what it really is all about. So I appreciate the opportunity, and I have to beg my leave because I'm now going to a veterans event for our conference. So Heather, EJ, thank you very much.